I will be demonstrating the one-hand technique to construct a square knot using hand ties. And notice that I have the Ethicon knot tying board actually upside down, and so this portion of the knot board is toward me. In addition, we have this taped down. They do have these little suction cups on the bottom here to help secure this knot board to a desk as you practice. It's really important to have this secure because it's somewhat annoying not to have it secure. Now I have this rope, and notice that I don't have gloves on my hands. And what I'd like to have you do is to begin to learn the hand ties using this rope, which is humongous suture material. I will demonstrate later using gloves and a number two suture material the same techniques. However, to practice, it's really important when you first start out to understand that depending on how the suture is looped around the tissue that you're tying, will determine which throw of a knot that you're going to create first. Please recall that a knot is comprised of two throws. What I'd like to have you do to construct a one-hand square knot is to take the end of the suture, the short end of the suture, pass it down underneath and around in this fashion. Now notice I have the suture material, in this case the rope, at the tips of my fingers, my thumb and middle finger, and I've deliberately put my index finger out such as this. This is the way I'd like to have you start a one-hand technique. It is really important to have the suture material on the tips of your fingers. A common mistake is to have it back like this, and it's really, really difficult to complete a hand tie with the suture material not at the tips of your fingers. So the first throw is I'm going to take my index finger, deliberately come around the suture like this. So that's a half a loop. I'm going to put the complete the loop, and then I'm going to use my index finger to come underneath, trap, and bring the end of the suture, short end of the suture, toward me. Now another common mistake is being confused about where your hands start and where they end up. My right hand started away from me and now is toward me. I'm halfway through the suture pattern. Next, I take the suture now in between the tips of my thumb and index finger, roll my middle and ring fingers around to create half a loop, complete the loop, and now I'm going to use my middle finger to go around, trap between my middle finger and ring finger, the end of the suture, and bring it through the loop. Notice now that my hand is again where it started. I started here, halfway through, my right hand is here. I complete the pattern, my right hand is back where I started. And notice that I have a square knot created but with a one-hand technique. Okay, this is a one-hand technique to create a square knot. There's always a question of why this is called a one-hand versus a two-hand technique, because basically both hands are involved. And you'll see as I demonstrate the two-hand technique the difference, but let me just show you or demonstrate using one hand only. So this is a one-hand square knot using only one hand.